Well, hello there, friends, and welcome to Little Nightmares. I'm playing today via Vorpex on my Oculus Quest 2 using a link cable. So here we are, guys. I've been excited for this one for a while. You know, I sometimes avoid Vorpex because of the stigma. It just kind of, when you think about using Vorpex, you automatically get all of these visions in your mind of tweaking settings and doing a bunch of junk that you really don't want to, you know, you really don't feel like doing most of the time. Most of the time you just want to put your headset on and play. But what I fail to recognize most of the time is that there are a great many games, especially games like Little Nightmares, that you can play on the immersive screen that are just plug and play. You load the profile, you boot the game, and you play. And this is a game that I've looked forward to playing for quite some time. And in light of our recent Beat It challenge, I felt like there's no time like the present. So we're finally going to get into this thing. My first time ever playing it. I've never watched more than 5 minutes of a playthrough. I think I'm really going to dig it, and I think you are too. So let's check it out. We're going to play a new game. My wife played 5 minutes just a moment ago, just so I could show her the magic of Vorpex. But for those of you who don't know, Vorpex is a 3D driver that allows you to play flat games or traditional video games in VR with full 3D. And it doesn't work for every game, but it works for many games. And when it works, it's amazing. And by all accounts, this is one of those games that's just amazing in Vorpex. Anyway, let's play. Blurry vision in the distance slowly comes into focus. It's a lady. And here we are. Immediately, the depth of field is very apparent. There are dust particles floating all around in the air. The water is in the foreground. It's proper 3D, as if the game were made to be played this way. That's the magic and beauty of Vorpex. It doesn't seem like a mod at all. It seems like it's naturally 3D. Looks like you can interact with the objects that are just lying around here, these cans. I want to know who this kid is sleeping in a suitcase on the street. From the streets, yo. What are those? See, this is all that I really want. No, I'm not gonna say it's all that I really want. But this is the main thing that attracts me to VR. Is I want my games to have some depth. 3D depth. You know, I don't need to be completely immersed in the world. Although, I mean, that's always awesome. But a little 3D depth and a pair of headphones to give me 3D audio, and that's all the immersion I need. Let's see. There we go. So automatically, something like Vorpex. Oopsies, I hit the wrong button. Alright, how do I crouch? There we go. Trap door here or something. Starting to hear things howling and growling in the distance. Ship. I was wondering why things were kind of swaying here. You notice how, I don't know if it's coming across to you, but there's a little bit of movement. I thought maybe my mouse was malfunctioning and causing the game to behave in abnormal ways, but now things are starting to come into focus a little bit. Broom. Who's that? Is that a doll? It's a doll of the lady that we were just dreaming about. Or having nightmares about, rather. Can we kick it off the edge? I don't trust it. Get out of here, lady. We don't like your kind. Got this old couch. There's a chair floating. Hanging. Multiple chairs hanging. Can we push this pan over there to catch the water? I guess it's too heavy. What about this bucket? Too heavy as well. Thought I saw something looking through that porthole at me just now. See the hole in the door? There was movement behind there. I caught in my peripheral vision. Let's see, if I was this kid and I was just sleeping in a suitcase on the street, I think I might have to take the opportunity to catch a nap real quick on this bed. There we go. You gotta jump and then you grab with the trigger. It's two different buttons. Even this mattress. Oh man. That's not a chair. I mean, that's a chair, but that's not a chair hanging. No, that is a man. You're not a chair. You're a man. This gameplay brought to you by Dr. Squatch. Take this man's toilet paper, he don't need it. When I was your age, we used to play soccer with toilet paper. Well, take the chair out. See, that's the thing that really has attracted me to the idea of playing this game. Is it may look like the format of a child's side-scroller game, but the subject matter, this is legit horror. Like, there's disturbing things in this game, or so I've been told. So that's why I've been so anxious to play it. All right, we gotta push something over there and jump off of it. Am I right? Because it's too high up to grab. We gotta get this chair. So I just hit a button or something to bring up my Vorpex menu. I don't know if you can see it on your screen there. I'm trying to figure out how to close it. Okay, you just hit the back button to close it. So I must have let the door close on me again, I suppose. There we go. We got it this time. Beautiful lighting effects for this type of game, to be quite honest. The lights and shadows all play significantly into the atmosphere in these types of horror games. Is that a Frigidaire? Looks like there's blood running out of this refrigerator. Are those footprints? Looks like there's footprints on the ground leading up to this refrigerator. Bloody footprints. Can I open it? What's up there? Can I climb? I can. What is that? Oh, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. Oh. I thought I was doing something special. No. I'm supposed to be going up here. Hey, get off of me. I'm dead. Was that an eel? Did I even take a step back? No, I'm in the exact same spot. That looks like something I should be interacting with. There's another one of those eel things hanging there. You see it? Two of them. Three of them. We need some means to fight these things. Alright, there's a switch up there. Two more of those. I just want to shoot them. I feel like I should be playing, what was that other side-scroller game we played in Vorpex? I don't remember what it was called. But there's another game like this. It's like an action shooter. It was really cool. My friend Pedro. That's what it's called. I feel like I should have Pedro here shooting those things down as they hang there. Can I not climb? What is my... Okay, I guess I'm pressing in on the left thumbstick, and that's what's bringing up my vortex options in the menu, which is helpful, I suppose, when I need that sort of thing. All right, so what's the move here, guys? This, maybe? It's too high to grab. I don't think I can burn my way through it. Oh, I gotta pull the boards out. And we have a lantern. I wonder if these lanterns are like save points or something. I don't know how the saving works in this game. Oh shit! Oh no. Look at this nasty crap. It's like the Night of the Creeps in here. They're like leeches. Alright, so there's a lantern. Maybe I can light this one. Yeah. Yeah, so I saw a little icon come up in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen when I lit that. So these absolutely are save points. Which is cool. It's like Lies Beneath. What are these little gnome things that are running around? See, I can't imagine playing this on a flat screen. Like, in the headset here, playing it in 3D, it seems like this game was meant to be played like this. Like, there's so much depth here. I mean, the map, it's a 3D map that you're running around on. So, that concept of playing this game in two dimensions just seems weird to me. Oh, the lights are on. Okay, so we gotta be quick, huh? Can we make that jump? Is that what we're supposed to do? I think that's what we're supposed to do, is make this jump. But still, man, I mean, that's... I don't know, man. Maybe we're supposed to jam that thing somehow. Because I didn't even really get close to it. How would we go about that, you think? Can we bend this pipe or something? That don't make sense. Thank you. Hold X to sprint, it says. Okay. So now I got to figure out which... I mean, unless it's giving me PlayStation controls, which is very possible. Steam's really good about that. You know, when you're using the PlayStation controllers, a lot of these Steam games will automatically detect that and give you the right button configuration in game. So we're going to hold actual X here and see if that allows us. Well, I think X is the jump button, though. So we're going to hold square. Yeah, that's it. Square. We made it. Yeah, so there's a door there, but we're going to look around a little bit first. There's two ways to go. We can go this way, or we can go through that door over there. And by the way, guys, you know, you heard me mention at the top that this was for the Beat It Challenge. And for those of you who don't know, that is a competition that we're... There you are. It's a competition that we're having on my podcast channel, The Virtual Strangers. The link is in the description for that. You know, without going into all of the rules, the contest is built around finishing games in VR. And you can use traditional flat games, but they have to be played inside the headset. It has to be played in its entirety. You have to finish it, and you have to play every minute on video. So either in a stream or in a video like this. So the fact that I'm playing this, you know, you guys can 2+2, and it's certainly going to be 4. I'm going to play the game through in its entirety. So if you're enjoying this video, then you're in luck, because we're going to play the whole thing. What is that? Rapunzel, Rapunzel. Let down your bed sheets. Alright, so looks like we found the bathroom, right? Looks like some kind of a washroom. Alright, game saved. I hear a mouse squeaking around here somewhere. There he is. There he was. So yeah, this is the bathroom right here. This is the outhouse. Can I get up there and use it? I can. All right, so we have looks like we have an electrified door. I think there's a problem here that we need to deal with. Don't know exactly what to do about it, but what's the move here, friends? Oh, all will be revealed in time, huh? By the way, look, check out how awesome this virtual living room is that we're sitting in and playing. Everything's super sharp. Very realistic looking. And then you look out the window at this cityscape. I mean, I think that's the Empire State Building or something out there, isn't it? Sears Tower or something. It looks like the Empire State Building. That's what I think it is. Beautiful. Sounds like it's on a timer or something. We're gonna get through here. Alright, there we go. Some building blocks. Oh, this looks like a puzzle. The train set over there. We're in a kid's room. I don't know exactly what I'm supposed to be doing here. I'm just climbing because I can. It's all very cool looking in VR, by the way. Very detailed. Yeah, so same deal here. We've got another electrified door that we have to deal with. Gotta find the switch. Can I climb up there? I guess not. Well, let's go find this the switch, I guess then, huh? What is it? You think maybe that I'm supposed to make it through both of these rooms? Well, I have it switched off. No, I can't get back into the other room, so that doesn't make sense. Oh, I see. Now I see what I'm supposed to do. We absolutely are going to have to make a run for it. So here we are, we made it yet again. What's in those boxes? Oh, that's cool. What is it? Petrify people that stand in the light or something? Tried to run, but I got caught by the bed rail. Alright, get ready. Go. Well, let me up there. There's a save point. I know I can get up there. Oh, crap. There we go. Well, there's that little gnome guy. We'll call him Gnome Chomsky. like the Valve gnome. That's not the way up there, is it? Well, there is a way. Oh, I think I see. Yeah, here we go. Got you, bitch. So if that's, hold on a second here. I need to see something. I'm sure it'll all be in vain, but I gotta see something. I don't know what's up here. If that's the way to go down there, then what's up here? Hmm. Okay, so we found another one of these dolls. Oh, you're supposed to break them. No, I want to go back. Because I didn't break the one. Oh, that sucks, man. That was all the way back at the beginning. I would have to start all over again to break that thing. What is that? Okay, apparently there's some bigger stuff that we have to be worried about here. What was that? An orphan or something? I mean, I saw something move up there. I guess I gotta get out of here, but... Oh, I remember I climbed this stuff here, right? I think it's cool that there was two ways to go, because I could have totally followed that little gnome guy through that hole. But I decided to climb up a little higher and found a whole other way to go. So I wonder if there's branching paths like that all through the game, giving it ultimate replayability. What'd you eat, baby? Are you hungry? What's up? Guess maybe I need to get some food from the mess hall here. Thank you. Get it. Oh no, you shouldn't take food from strangers. Especially virtual strangers. You have a friend. Thank you, friend. Thank you. There's looks like they've got the rip ready for the next one, huh? I hear something. I don't know what it is, but it does not sound like something I want to see. Must be behind this. Well, I don't know. Let's find out. Save point. See the switch over there. Something tells me if I jump from here, I'm gonna be screwed. So we'll go the way we're supposed to go. Crap. So I did the thing again where I press my left stick and the Vorpix menu comes up. And I fell to my death. There's the switch we're looking for, huh? Well, that's in a whole other room, huh? Hmm. Interesting. I guess that's not what we were supposed to do. To do here. I feel like I should be running and jumping and grabbing that, but it didn't work before. Well, it did work. So So here we are again. Crap. There it got me. Motherfucker. Again. I can't push those boxes over here. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I wonder what happens if I let the thing see me. That's what happens. Here we go again. Come on now. Did it. Start of a new level. Or is it a, or are there boss fights? I gotta think there would be a boss fight, right? So which way do we go? Let's go see what's in this other room. If I can get out. That might just be a window. Can't tell what's in there. Mr. Tumnus. Alright, we're just gonna go back the other way. To hell. Thank you. Found another turlet. Well, there's a key over there. Well, we can climb these like a ladder. Oh, is this another dude? It's just laundry. Okay. Look at that, isn't that crazy? Okay, there's the lock that I need the key for. I wonder what the switch is for. One, two, three, four, five. Oh, these bitches got nothing. Six to deal with. Seven. Me when I get eight. To them, nine. And kick their ten ass. Flip that switch. Can I get a suitcase up on the carpet? That was up. We got that ball we can throw. I don't know if that does us any good or not, though. There we go. I don't know what that noise is, but it does not sound... It doesn't sound good. Did it. Oh, there's one of those little monkey clap toys. My trap now? What's it? What gives? Do I have to kill myself? What's up? That's not cool. Alright, here goes. Goodbye, cruel world. So we did it. We're here. There's a button up there I actually have to hit. It worked. Okay, there's another button. Basement. Oh no, she's hungry again. Or he. She's hungry again. Eat one of these rats. There's something. It's a trap, but what are you gonna do? Uh-oh. We in trouble, bro. But this is like Subway Jared's basement. Chris D'Elia. Out, yo. Hey there, how you doing? Just gonna borrow your cage for a minute. I wonder how I'm supposed to do that. You swing. Okay. And I'm in an empty room now. There we go. Well, there's a guillotine. Look, there's a bloody guillotine. I guess if I was this dude and all these little kids were breaking in my house like little mice, I'd probably do the same thing. What the hell's going on here? How am I supposed to get around this dude so he don't wrap me up like that? Probably need to be a little quicker. Oh, look at that. Just packing these dead bodies up and wrapping them in paper. Got me. Okay, I see where I'm supposed to go now. I gotta make a run for it. Okay, I gotta get this. Shoes. It's a lot of shoes. That's a lot of shoes. Okay. Wow. What's in the shoes, bro? Got me. Shoe monster. I don't even know where I'm at. It got me wherever I'm at. No! No! I did it again. I brought my Vorpix menu up and it stopped me in my tracks. Somebody's been hanging up rats in here. Trap. Oh crap. Stop it. I got nothing to throw. As gruesome as this game has been, I'm surprised that it doesn't just show him what he's gonna do to me. Really don't see what I'm supposed to be going for here. Give me that light. There's a loose board, isn't there? The loose board on the ground. I missed. There we go. Okay, so we have a bunch of puppies in this room. What's that guy doing? Is he leaving? Playing with his toys. Certainly looks happy, doesn't he? So maybe I wasn't even supposed to come down here. But how else would I have gotten through the door, though? This is the way up here, isn't it? Got me. Thank you. Get up there. Sounds like he's going where I'm going. I might want to turn around. This is cool. No! Stop it. Oh, we're gonna get a drop of piano on this dude. Oh yeah. I was hoping that at some point it was gonna let me kill this guy. What it? I think I let go of the button. I must have let go of the button for a second. It's okay though. So I'm totally gonna need to drop a piano on this dude. Because there just happens to be a freaking piano hanging in this house. Seriously, he's up here? Crank. What the hell, man? I've made bigger falls than that before without dying. So we can put him where we want him with sound. It's interesting to know. I still haven't figured out where the hell I'm gonna find this crank at though. Cause I gotta go out there. Got the crank now. Question is, how do I get back? Thank you. Oh no. We're getting there, friends. We're getting close. Candle there. I need to light that. It would be very helpful. Not have to keep repeating that little bit there over and over again. I'm trying to figure out in my mind here what exactly we're going to do after the thing rises up. We jump on it again. I mean, I was pretty sure we were going to drop the piano on the dude's head, but I'm not seeing how that's exactly going to happen here. Come on now. Can't believe we didn't drop a piano on this guy's head. Or you jump over his hand. Is it eventually going to give out? Is that what we're waiting on? I think I've got to pull that thing down on his head. I love it. It hurt, didn't it, you bastard? I've got his freaking floppy arms in the room with me. It's my trophy. Friends, that is awesome. It's so cool. Wow, that was crazy. All right, so I think this is probably going to be a pretty good place to stop, but we're going to keep going. Just need to take a little break. Because we've been going on this thing for a good long while now, or at least it feels that way. But what do you think? I think this game is twisted and I love it, and I knew it would be, and that's why I played it. Don't tell me this guy's still in operation even without his friggin' big floppy arms. But let me know what you think down in the comments down below. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, why don't you help support by clicking the big red button as well as the one with the bell on it to keep up with all of the videos here on Lethal Weasel VR. With that said, friends, I'd like to thank you all for watching, and we will see you another day from another game. Thanks again. Bye-bye.
Name is Mr. T. First name is Mr. Middle name is that period. Last name is T. Now everybody listen up. We're gonna talk about strangers. You gotta learn how to deal with them. You gotta.